Hello. Hello? Hello. So, I realize I haven't eaten anything since 3 p.m. when we had Thanksgiving, so I was like, you know what? It's time. It's time to eat the McRib. That is some mediocrity. Some excellent mediocrity, though. All right. Why am I all over here? Mad New Year 7, 10 months in a row.
Thanks.
We're going hard now, boys. True facts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Swag. I can't spell 6 months in a row, halfway to your nerd day.
One, thanks.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Swag. Crusader Canyo, 10 months. Happy Nerdsgiving. Happy Nerdsgiving to you too. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Swag. McDonald's fries are alright. Sometimes they're bad. No, I don't eat them. This time they're okay. Then you get weird ones like this. Definitely doesn't want a French fry.
Very good.
For as good as McDonald's fries can be. Burger King over McDonald's fries? I don't know about that. I've had both. Burger King's just taste. Ever since they changed them, they just taste weird. I don't like them. They're okay. I love Steak and Shake fries. That's the fries I love. Steak and Shake has great fries. Sagacious Euro at 1200 bits. Shit, dude. Thanks, Sagacious Hero. You must have watched a lot of ads. McRibs are back. Let me show you. There it is. The one and only McRib sandwich. Oh yeah, I like Five Guys too. You know what? I've had a lot of McRibs in my day. This is a pretty good one. They made it pretty well. I'll give it up to McDonald's. They actually made this McRib pretty well. Because the thing is, right? I'm a very, like, picky eater. Not, like, picky as in I won't eat something. Picky as in my food has to be, like, cooked well. Like, it has to be... for example, how I didn't want to eat that one fry. Like, this fry, it's like a weird, like, kind of brown, deformed fry. I'm not gonna eat... That's what I mean by cooked well. Like, I'm looking for the good fries. Like, alright, that's a good fry. So, like... If this wasn't, like... If this was, like, kind of chewy, or it tasted off, I'd be like, I'm not eating this. Because I'm not gonna, like, put myself through something I don't want to just to, like, eat something that's not good for me. You know what I'm saying? Hello? Pretty good McRib.
Thanks.
Oh yeah, Chick-fil-A's got good fries. Forgot about that. Rinse Flower just subscribed. Thanks, Rinse Flower. Swag. The thing is, right, it's not just a fry. It's like a burnt or a not cooked very well fry. So, like, normally, I'll do that with any food. If it's not cooked well or it's burnt or it just isn't, like, right, I won't eat it. You know what I mean? You know how it is. I was gonna see if G-Mart was awake. But I don't think he is. I don't even know if he's home. One thing I don't like is the pickles. Because McDonald's pickles, or restaurant fast food pickles, just taste like if you took a pickle, like a normal pickle, and just dump like three times the amount of salt on it and like cut it in half so it was really thin. And like it tastes like it's out of a bag. I don't like those. Zeltrion's here. What a loser. What a nerd. Gage of Sage donated $10 off of my Black Friday shift and ready to enjoy my birthday evening with a relaxing bout of ASM nerd. Happy birthday, Gage of Sage. Wait, you had to work on your birthday. And had to work on, like, Black Friday. And your birthday's on Black Friday? Shit, dude. Where do you work? What do? You gotta work on Black Friday. False alarm, thought it was another pickle. It wasn't. Hey, what's happening? Ashley Nightmare dropping 100 bits. Save me from Boogar's Wrath. I can't do that. It's impossible to control Boogar's Wrath. You work at both Starbucks and Food Avenue in Target. Oh yeah, the Food Avenue thing. I don't know what that is. I take it as just the little place in the Target. I think we talked about it the other night. And Starbucks. Is it like one of those Target Starbucks as well? I take it it is. Prime rib, your favorite thing is the McRib in fast food places. It makes sense. So that is one prime fast food rib. Like, I was delaying getting it, and then I realized I hadn't eaten in 10 hours. And then I was like, I should probably just eat something. And this is kind of something, so... I never like eating the end part, though. It's always, like, the worst. It's like...
What is this end thing?
I don't want to eat that part. I like barbecue sauce, though. Get it a couple times a week. Shit, dude. I used to get it a lot, actually, back in the day, but I only get it like once now. Maybe twice, because I actually made it well. You know what? For them making it well, I'll take another bite. There we go. Oh, and an onion. What is happening in chat? Ashley Nightmare, 100 bits, build a wall, make Boogar pay for it. You know what? Keep giving me bits. That's what I'm gonna do. I'll build the wall. It'll be built out of bits. And we're gonna make Boogar pay for those bits. Switch this over to World of Warcraft, not World of Tanks. As for a couple of packets of barbecue, oh my god, that's pretty genius. You're a genius. You know how to eat your McRibs.
Wow. Thanks.
Okay.
Orion Blarg, 7-9 months in a row. I haven't had a Thanksgiving dinner in 11 years. Crendor, not like this. What? How would you have had a Thanksgiving dinner in 11 years?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
Swag. Shit, dude. Quack of Dawn dropping 100 bits. I expect the reimbursement soon. And Jelfa dropping 100 bits. More bits. Thank you, thank you. We're gonna make that. We're gonna make Boogarp A for that wall.
Thanks.
He's gonna pay for it.
Believe me. Why would I lie to you? Saxton 42 resubbing 2 months in a row. Thanks, Saxton.
1, 2.
Swag. All right. Let's res. And I was gonna do the Soul Takers thing. Maybe find a group. Here we go. Hell yeah. Oh God. The Frost Hidden Appearance? What? What's that do? What's that do?
These wretches defile our sacred ground, collecting souls for their cursed queen. Finish them.
Hell yeah. Oh, the artifact weapon thing. Frosty cage. I see, I see, I see. Damn. I'm gonna be able to equip my second legendary in only like 4 or 5 hours. Pretty great. However, I don't have a second legendary. It's my big issue I'm going through right here. Go around like this way. Shit. Oh wait, Saxton 42 resubbed 2 months in a row. Thanks, Saxton.
1, 2, 3.
swag. Wait, what? How do I get in here? Oh my god, I shouldn't have released. Ooh, and I got my new artifact note. Link to my UI. If you go to my YouTube channel, I have a video that goes over all of my UI stuff. Go inside the cave. Down here. Cave's down here. Oh my god, let's go back. Oh, down here. Shit, dude. Okay. There we go. Res.
These wretches defy.
Hell yeah, back in time.
Ground, collecting souls for their cursed queen. Finish them.
Yes. Morning, Tom. How are you? How was your Thanksgiving? Oh my god, the cursed cruiseman. Shoulders. Damn, I want that. Oh wait, no, I don't. Is it worth using one of my rerolls here? I don't think it is, right? It's probably definitely not using a worth using a bonus loot thing. I get my legendary though. Should I reroll it for my legendary? That's good, nobody brought up politics. Dude, our EU guild over here is 7 out of 7 heroic. And I know we're 2 out of 3 normal. I don't know if we're 3 out of 3 normal yet. We might have been. Pretty sure we are. What are we? can't reroll legendaries. Damn. Alright, I'll save it. Bloop. We are 7-7 North Citizen Heroic, upcoming raid Friday. Where is it? I mean, we killed the bosses last week when I was at whatever the thing's called. Well, we did raid with a guild. It's me, G-Mart, Benji, and this is Sam's guild. Sam was supposed to be in the guild, and then he quit WoW after, like, a day, so he didn't. And then we stayed, and I get carried very hard. But, you know what? Sometimes that's what you need. Speaking of which, we raid tomorrow. Hell yeah. Hell yeah. Hell yeah, hell yeah. Heh-heo. Yeah, he's gonna raid when he switched to EU and power level his character that... He's like, guys, obviously I'm gonna get to max level on this server. Obviously. Why would I quit? There's no reason for me to quit. It doesn't make any sense why I would quit. Then he quit.
Bro.
Browse.
Take your time.
Take your time.
Enjoy.
What do we got here? I'll throw out a bunch of barracudas.
May the mists protect you.
May the mists protect you. There's a Kren guild? What? The guild is dead. Wait, what? Who lied in an interview? Why would Sam have an interview? What interview did he lie in? My level's 869.
Greetings. Good luck.
I didn't shave, I just trimmed my beard. Still there. I don't know what Jesse is. I know Jesse's been raiding too. Where's my add-on? Why's my add-on not working? Wait, what are my world quests? Oh, I guess I did a Valrajar one. I might as well go do another one. Here we go there.
What brings you?
Chip tug. Okay, Murky's egg. Maybe I'll do that. Which one was this? Drelkjar slain. Which one's the one where you just fly around? I don't think I have that one, so that sucks. Oh shit, the Tunic of Smoldering Ire. That actually has a lot of crit, and I think I need it. So I'd like to do that. Especially if it gets upgraded to like 870. That'd be cool. I'll do these first. Let's see, which ones are close? Those are easy. That's easy. I'm gonna go do. I'll fly here.
Be careful.
Metro carries them. I mean, I get carried in my guild, so I can't say anything. I do like the lowest DPS. Okay. I can obviously hit those high notes. You ever play the game where you click on like a random hashtag on Facebook and then you see all the responses to it and then you just click random people that have responded and just look at their Twitters? I do that sometimes. I think it's fun. It's like, who's this person? They're just like, there I am, and you're just like, wow, cool. I don't want to get to know you. And then you move on. Yeah, it's like people watching from home, exactly.
Cat, hello.
By the way, I'm working on the WoW ASMR video. I might break it down into various, like, categories. Like, one might be nature. So, like, I think the first one would be nature, and it would just be like waterfalls and pools of water and rain and windstorms and snow, like all that stuff, or just the like ambient noises. That's what I'm thinking. Where am I supposed to go here? Tip-tog. Wait, do I have to kill these two? I guess so. That's the main reason I want to do it, because I love the environmental sounds in WoW. And a lot of people take them for granted. Like, they're actually really good environmental sounds. Like, hold on, after I get these guys. I didn't do like an actual ASMR video, I did like a little like how to win it ASMR video. I mean like a full blown, like hour long, just ASMR sounds. For example, if we go over here, turn off the music, turn up the ambience, alright, let me just turn up the volume. listen to that. You hear the birds. You hear the, like, water. You hear the wind. Here there's, like, the cannon or whatever in the background, but I mean, other zones have a lot nicer ambient noise. So that's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm gonna be doing. Alright, what else do I gotta kill here? Up here? Oh, the skirmish.
Thanks.
Yeah. And then I'll probably do like city sounds. I'll do a bunch of stuff. I think it'll be fun. So you should head over to youtube.com/wildcrowddoor and put on notifications, subscribe, resubscribe, donate to Drop Bits. You can't do that on YouTube, but that's okay. You can do it here. JeffL0320 subscribed 30 months in a row. Shit, dude. Thanks, Jeff.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30.
Swag. Vezjir underwater sound in the shimmering expanse. Interesting. It's very specific. I'm gonna put that down somewhere. Let's see. Notepad. Let's keep this little notepad open over here. Sound of people complaining about not getting their legendary. Here's the thing. I used to be one of those people. I'd be like, come on, guys. Let's just, can we just... And now that I got my legendary, I'm like, hell yeah. This is awesome. Hey, what was I talking about? I legit just, like, got distracted. No, I don't remember what I was talking about. Oh, legendaries. Yeah, I got the legendary helmet, but I still need my second legendary. That's what I wanted to say. I really like the Dragon's Breath legendary, too. I can do, like, super AoE nukes with it. Oh yeah, the Undercity Throne Room. I could do that for like a Halloween one, but it'd be a while away because we just said Halloween. As someone who loves sounds, I will spend a lot of time going around listening to a lot of sounds. I also have teleport, which is very nice because I can just teleport all over the world and get places quickly, hence... why mages are the best. YOLO swag, mage for life. Aside from my priest and druid. I like them too, but I like mages. Ooh, that's a good noise. Let's head over here. Take out some Mightstone savages. Let's head over here. Take out some Mightstone savages. Yeah. Woo! Like that. Light them up. Light them up. Oh, this song's old now. Oh my god, this guy's really gonna try to kill me? Really, dude? Really, dude? I could have killed him easily too. What am I doing? Oh good, it's right down there. Good humming sounds and Tempest Keep. Oh yeah, Tempest Keep and all those ones probably got some good sounds in there. Where'd he go? Where'd he go? Is he running? Is he running? Is he scared? Where'd you go? You go. He's gone. Scared, dude. All right, let's go. Where is this guy? Tiptog the Lost. I didn't see him over here when I was last here. He's got to be around here. Maybe he's in a cave? Is he in a cave? What? It's like a little box that pops up when this guy I hover over him. Is that Tiptog? No. What? Are you serious? What? Oh my god, I got distracted and lost. Bah! There's two of them! Let me 1v1 them, you loser. God, I hate PvP realms. I really do. I never kill anyone, aside from people who try to kill me. And then I just die, or I get ganked by rogues, or just multiple people out in the wild. It's just, I just don't like PvP realms. I also rarely PvP. Oh wait, Tiptog's over here. There he is. He's like clawing the tree. Stop clawing the tree. It's a good tree. Hell yeah, you did it. Shit. Damn, I got the shitty robes. They didn't upgrade. They do have more crit though. But I'd rather just run that dungeon and probably get some decent ones, maybe. Actually, are there any things I can buy here for, like,
glory to being revered?
I already got him.
Dang. To your enemies.
Gosh. Hey, yeah, turn the music back on.
Hail, champion.
Hail. Where else to go? Actually, I just go do like these two right over here.
May your battles end in victory.
Oh, Jesus! All right. Let's go get this guy first. LFR can drop legendaries, really? Okay.
We have a target for you in this area. Be vigilant.
Fleurag's the Grave's Chill. Get out of my way. I also want some, like, did I go past it? I think I did. Oh, I think he's, like, around here. Your leg. Where are we at? Where are we at?
I am not defeated.
Toy. Get the toy.
Go get it. He just stands there and watches it. Lunaris 13 dropping 100 bits. Went through like five singing sloth commercials farming bits tonight, so thought I should give you some. Thanks, dude. I appreciate the singing sloth bits. Dude, by the way. Oh shit, there he is! Let's get ready to rock and roll, rock and roll. We're popping it! Pyroblast. Hell yeah. Give me the resources. Alright, well, got all those done. Legendary coming up. First we'll do the artifact power. That's a lot of artifact power I get now. Shit, dude. Get our legendary. All right, that's not a legendary ass. Well, so so much for that one. Alright, let's go High Mountain Nelthalrian's Lair and get that thing. Dungeon Finder. Specific dungeon. Nelthalrian's Lair. Audio now working. Hold on. Nelthalrian's Lair. Nope, definitely working. Audio is definitely working.
Hey, go get it.
By the way, if you're wondering what this giant thing is, I used to have a chair back there. Now,
we bought this, like, big-ass...
It's called, like, a Papasan chair from Pier
Thanks.
1. Dude, we've been wanting to buy this thing because of how soft it is for, like, 2 years. And I was like, you know what? I think this might be it. This might be the time. So it fit really well back there. And now, we got it. UTA17 just subscribed. Thanks, UTA17. Swag. That was a good high five.
Look at this. Look at how good this looks.
Super soft. That's what I want to say. Oh yeah, these pajama pants, dude. Got them at Costco. They had, these were like the softest pajama pants. As someone who works from home, the vast majority of the time, these pajama pants are worn a lot. And these are like some of the softest pajama pants I think I've ever owned. Like, they are amazing. And I got, it was like $20, and you get two pairs of them at Costco. It's,
Hey, what are you doing?
What are they? Nautica? Nausicaa? Nautica. I think it's Nautica. Yeah, Nautica. Nautica pajamas. Men's pajama pants, men's, dude. These are like the best sweatpants. Not sweatpants, pajama pants. Yeah, Nautica. The Pepsins are great, but vacuum it out weekly. Tons of dead skin build up on them. Shit, dude. I'll make sure to vacuum it then. It was like, we got it for $250. It's $250, but I think it's a pretty good deal. I mean, most of the other furniture we got was like cheap, like IKEA furniture anyway. So it's like, we can spend a tiny bit more. Some people spend like $1,000 on furniture pieces, and I'm like, no. No thanks. I also bought this like $50 little thing to go next to it at Target. This,
what is it? It's like a little, what's it called? Hold on, I'll show you.
Cute.
You can see it in the corner. See that little like desk thing? It's got like the zombie dragon on it. It's got a lamp.
I liked it. It's a nice little like table stand thing for the plant, or the, like,
the lamp.
But it's supposed to have a drawer that goes in it, right?
It's supposed to have a drawer.
And the drawer, like, you have to build it. And so I was building it. Look at this shit. I'm gonna show you.
Your drawer, right? Yeah, your drawer. It fits in, right? All this is good. You're building the drawer. Then, this other
on to the other side of the drawer, right? Where is it? I didn't build it wrong. I've built so much IKEA furniture in my day that I know how to do this. I know how to work with particle board, all right? So then... Hold on, I gotta accept this. Except... Look at this. You can see... I don't even know how to show it.
Is the
worst. This is it.
You see that
it's shitty. Call them up and yell at them. Give me a cart that fits. Yeah. It'll actually fit. Oh my god. The short piece to the front. It'll fit if I just cut it. Like, if I just go ahead and, like, saw it down a bit, it'll be fine. So that's what I'm gonna end up doing. But just the fact that they did it incorrectly always makes me mad. So I'm like, I didn't pay, or I guess technically you pay that it's like cheap, so it's like they don't care. But I'm still like, I should get some quality stuff, right? I paid $50 for this shitty thing, and it should be at least able to be put together and then get wobbly. Not just not be able to put together. Either way. If I take a job designing IKEA furniture, I'd do it for a little while. You hate all your IKEA furniture? Well, I have an IKEA... bookcase, bed frame, couch, which Cat has torn to shit. Cat loves to just, like, claw at the sides of the couch. Hold on, I got a DPS, so they're not like, can you please DPS? Yeah, he's... He, like, goes up to it, and he does the, like, claw thing on all the, like, corners and the top of it. And then we tried to be like, don't do that, but he also didn't care. Because he's a cat. Let's see, what else is there? There was the dining room table, and we got rid of that. Dining room chairs. The DVD shelf. Forgot about that one. Actually, a lot of our stuff is IKEA. They should not possess. Tell you what, though. It's cheap, and it works. Oh, yeah, and the coffee table. Our coffee table is also that, but...
You would lead these intruders against us. Darkly cannot control the hammer.
You can teach Cass not to coffin as well. I think it may have been past the point of teaching him. No, he just gave up. I'm like, you know what? I'm not going to keep this couch anyway. So, whenever we move, we'll just get a new couch.
Smash!
Also, the coffee table we have, we either built it poorly or it's poorly made because it wobbles a lot. And it's pretty annoying.
Big problem.
Nothing beat rock. Dude, I like super out DPS everyone. I'm not used to that. I'm used to getting out DPS. I hope our allies can then your coffee table in a dumpster. The thing is, the IKEA coffee tables and all that look pretty great. There's like one, it's like the same thing, but it's like, it's only $50. We'll probably buy that one. Slaves to dig at the bones of my father. He does not know the
powers he meddles with. Where are you hiding your food, maggot?
Please, maggot.
You've already taken all the
food we have.
Shut up and give me your food. Give me your lunch, buddy.
You're not fighting.
But please,
you're not
we're just trying to eat. We would like to share our food.
I don't care.
They definitely aggroed. Oh my god. Here we go. What are they? Are they like fighting something? Oh my god! Well, that'll explain it. Instead of being like, hey guys, why don't we go get this world quest guy? They're just like, we pulled it. Neat.
Our waters are safe to drink again, thanks to you.
Thanks to you.
Is that the only one we need from here? And then Dargul. Okay, yeah. So there's that guy, and then the Basilisk guy. Thank God we don't need the Basilisk guy. That guy's annoying. This guy's like right over there. This is heroic. I mean, it's just a heroic dungeon. It's not like it's practically normal, especially when you're 869 item level.
Up.
Move. Everybody needs it. Move. Happy face. Great. Dude, I was gonna play Pokemon after I stream tonight. I haven't really played too much. I'm like at the part where you get past the Tauros. And he's like, hey, the Tauros is blocking the road. And then you get past them, and then they're like, check out the shopping area. That's where I am right now. So, yeah. I want to play it and get a little deeper into it. Pick Pop Leo. I didn't put up the Christmas tree yet. Probably get a new one, actually. The other one we were using is getting kind of old. It's probably gonna buy a new one. Do I ever sleep? Of course I sleep. I sleep from like 6 a.m. to like 1 p.m. An amazing sleep schedule.
Head, hello!
I forgot that I even had mining. Trubbish V just subscribed. Thanks, Trubbish V. I want you to see your heroes die. Swag. Swag, swag, swag.
High mountain itself rises against you.
Nuzlocke? What's Nuzlocke?
Go ahead and run! It will change nothing. You will never wield the power.
Oh, we're in a boss fight. I didn't even realize that. A playstyle? Oh, Pokemon hard mode. The thing where Pokemon die, they die in real life. Oh, I see. Did nobody really pay attention to which one it was? I mean, I didn't, but I figured someone else did.
Go ahead and run! It will change nothing!
I don't think I'd do that. I like playing Pokemon like a normal Pokemon, but I'm also a normie Pokemon player, where I'm like, oh boy, I haven't played Pokemon in forever, since like Silver and Gold. Like, last time I really played a Pokemon game was Silver and Gold. So... that's me. don't know, like, any of the new Pokemon. Eve is free to play or anything like that. I actually have some East, like, Eve stuff. I probably put, like, 100 to 200 hours into Eve. I have a really good, like, mining ship. Well, it used to be good. It's probably terrible now. But, I don't know. Eve was just one of those games where I just sit and chill.
Mother of worms, arise!
Yes.
If they complete this summoning, our passage to Darkrai will be blocked. She comes. Naraxxus will feast on your foes.
Oh, Jesus.
Oh, Jesus.
Yes. Wait, no.
So far, I'm really liking the Sun and Moon, though. I think it's pretty fun. It's weird not playing like a Pokemon that's like a side scroller. That's all I'm really used to. Or black and black and white for that matter. I guess the other one was color, but like, it wasn't that great of color. You know what I'm saying? Good night, Shevanthuin. I can't. I'm terrible at names. Shevanthuin.
Strike it, Darkrai,
now!
It appears the treasure you seek will be found on the other end of this beast.
I got it.
The Tauren believed you were prophesied to seize my hammer!
Hell yeah.
Pathetic. Let them come. Witness the fate of those who stand against one worthy of wielding the power of a titan!
Hello, Tina. How was your Thanksgiving? Oh my god, I aggroed one with my dragon's breath. Shit, dude.
Rip them apart!
Have I done simulations on my mage for DPS and stuff? No, I don't really care enough.
Sorry, heroes. I must leave you now. Yet know this. I have witnessed your deeds with pride,
And oh, I am God. Sure you will not fail High Mountain in this final hour.
You won't fail High Mountain, right? No. Why would I fail High Mountain? I wouldn't
Rip
do that.
Them apart!
No.
Rip them apart!
Got back from the outlets by O'Hare. Oh, is that that? What's it called? Fashion outlet place.
Rip them apart.
It's the fashion outlet place, right?
I will break this world asunder before I let you take my hammer. The shaper and forger of this world?
Don't go there to the saying. Well, the only reason I know it, or know of it, is because during Chicago Comic Con, it happens at that place, the Donald Stevenson Center. And so it's easy. Instead of having to like pay to park and do all that, all you do is you go park at the outlets place, and then it's free. And you just walk a bit. But, on the way back, where I was like, hey, we should eat at their food court. Don't. They have the shittiest food court I think I've ever seen in my life. For those of you who don't know, this food court has, like, knockoff versions of, like, actual chains. So, for example, oh my god. Why are we fighting over here? Oh my god. So yeah, it has knockoff versions of like all the chains. One of them, instead of Panda Express, is called like Chinatown. And did I get a good? Did I get an upgrade?
It seeks a wielder who possesses
not really. Well, I get 1% more crit if I put it on, but I don't really care enough.
Dead and the hammer reclaimed. The drug broken.
What was I talking about? Oh yeah, Big Panda Express. So anyway, this place is so bad. It's so bad.
The power of the Mad King Gargroll is broken.
The food is like...
Now, there are other family matters that require my attention.
I can't even... I'd say, like, think of Panda Express, but worse. But I'm sure a lot of you are like, how can it be worse than Panda Express? It is. The chow mein is literally just, like, spaghetti and soy sauce. The chicken was, like, the worst chicken I've ever eaten. And I was like, dude. Chinatown. I've never wanted to eat more at a Panda Express in my life. Because it was so bad. I forgot what it's called. It's like China Walk, Chinatown, China something. The people working there looked extremely depressed, and now I know why. Whoa, I can equip two legendaries. Hell yeah. The other one was like some like weird, shitty chicken place. And then there's this Mexican place. It's like really bad burrito taco things. Just none of it. Don't get any of it there. So yeah, it's an experience. The only good thing is they got a Sparrow. It's a really bad Sparrow, but it's still Sparrow, so it tastes the same. And then they also got this like Japanese food place. Most malls like have the Japanese food place. I forget what it's called, but they give you like chicken teriyaki and like rice or noodles and like vegetables or whatever. And it's pretty good. It's good enough to eat and not hate yourself. So that's what we get over there. Let's get out of here. Did you go to Woodfield? I did go to Woodfield. It was insane. It was insanity. But yeah, Sarku Japan, that's the one. That's the one. They got one of those, it's pretty good.
Chronakai Christo.
Chronakai Christo. Artifact research notes. Alright, I'll keep it going.
Favor the road
traveled. Increase the damage dealt by ignite. Hell yeah. Phoenix Flame? Which one's... Oh, Phoenix Flame. Shit, dude. That's pretty good. Damn, you want to go to Woodfield tomorrow? I mean, they'll probably be sold out of a bunch of shit tomorrow. It was super crowded. It was insane. I had to, like, park, like, 8 years away. Walk across the, like, street, and then walk through the parking lot. It was Mad Men. However, I got a beanie half off, and I got sweatpants from Abercrombie half off. The only time I would ever buy anything there is if it's half off, and it was. And dude, Abercrombie had so many, it was filled with like either preppy like teenagers or just Asian people. I don't know why, it was just loaded with both of those. And then, like, a small amount of just, like, randos. But not even, like, hey, I'm Asian. Like, actual Asian-speaking people talking whatever language they are out loud, very loud. And I was like, why are there so many, like, legit Asian people here? They must love Abercrombie, then. I learned something about Abercrombie. I can't even say it right. Darn. Yeah, there's a line. What had a line? There's a line to get into H&M. Everybody wanted to go to H&M. And there was a line to get into, what's that one store? I don't know why people go there. It's like the jewelry one. You're Asian and hate those Asians. Yeah, what's that jewelry one? Pandora's or whatever? For some reason, people were lined up for, like, a mile just to get into that place. I'm like, I don't get it. Is their jewelry stuff that good? Is it just cheap? Is it, like, cheap good? Is it... I don't know. What else was there?
You have my undivided attention.
Top Crendor stores to go to. By Crendor stores, I mean things like IKEA. Obviously IKEA. Usually, like, I don't go to places like Abercrombie ever. Like I said, I saw the signs, like, 50% off, now's my chance. And I didn't even like that much stuff, but I found the sweatpants, and I was like, dude, these are pretty good sweatpants. So I got them. And then, the best mom gift you can get each year. That makes sense. Let's see. Overpriced charm bracelets that are supposed to have sentimental value. I was thinking of that. Let's see. What other stores were there? Oh my god. I love the candle store. Yeah. Starbucks lines were insane. However, I did go to Starbucks. That outlet mall is really shitty for Starbucks, though. They got like one Starbucks, and it's just a little kiosk thing. It's a really shitty Starbucks. And it's like crammed into a little area. What else is there? Oh yeah, the candle store. I said already. Then there's Disney store. Always go into the Disney store and check for Eeyore stuff. They got, I check Eeyore mugs. I check for new Eeyore, like, plushy things, and then I check the clearance section for Eeyore. And then if there's nothing, I just leave. let's see. Trying to, like, scout everything out. Usually I'll check American Eagle, because I like their hoodies. They have really shit hoodies this year. And, oh my god, American Eagle always has the worst checkout line. They have the worst checkout line, dude. yeah. And it didn't disappoint this time. The checkout line, like, legit had a guy. It had a guy, like, with a sign. And he was like, the line starts here. And he's, like, way in the back being like, line starts here. And I was like, nothing is worth waiting that long. Nothing. Unless, maybe I'd wait, like, 30 minutes if they were handing out, like, free money. Like, over $100 worth of free money. That's the only time I'd wait, like, 30 minutes. Maybe. I'd still probably rather just leave. It's like, whatever. I'll just pay the extra, like, $10. When nobody's here. Your friend's a manager at the Yankee Candle. Shit, dude. Well, they have two candle places. They got, like, Yankee Candle and they got White Barn. I like to smell both. What else is there? Hey, friend, I just want to say your awesome videos. The Hearthstone videos are bomb and keep me interested in the game. Thanks, man. Thanks, dude. I just have fun playing. That's my thing. I just like having fun. So if you like seeing me have fun, I hope that makes you have fun. oh, yeah, I went to Target tonight, too. I talked about all this in my Crencast on my YouTube channel that I made tonight. But, I mean, you're here already, so I may as well talk about it again. At Target, there's this one dude, and he had, like, oh my god, I can get it on my phone. Hold on. Can I? Where is it? This guy. Yeah. And he had two carts full of stuff, and he kind of looked like Sips, if you know who Sips is. Hold on, let me just get over here. Look at this, he looks like Sips. Or just a weird hoarding gremlin.
Drop it.
So he was legit. Here's the story behind that. I saw this woman buy three carts. She didn't literally buy them, she was just standing by them. And she was like standing, like, by the carts on her phone, and I was like, oh, are those, like, the carts for, like, items they're gonna put back on the shelves or something? Because it was just three carts filled with a bunch of shit. And I was like, yeah, it must be the, like, items they're putting back on the shelves or items nobody wants, they just throw in the cart. Nope. Those were carts filled with stuff they were buying. And I was like, oh my god. And so he came over and took two of them, and then, she took one. And then he's like, hey, where'd you go? And then she's like, I'm over here. And he's like, you still got that cart? And she's like, yeah, I got the cart. And he's like, okay, good. It's like, they're doing some, like, big scheme. Like, dude, you still got the cart. All right, we're good. Operation Buy Shit is still on. It's just like, okay. And he's like, dude, 4 for $10 Diet Cokes. And I was like, what? You're gonna buy Diet Coke on Black Friday? Whatever, man. Those were probably the best people I saw. There's also the guy in a cat head. I put that on my Snapchat. Hold on. Let me show you the guy in a cat head. It's kind of blurry. Let's see if you can see it. Can you see him? Kind of see him. It's a guy in a cat head, and he is just legit standing there being like, "Hey, buy stuff here. Come into our store, buy stuff. Hey, come into our store. Hey, I have a cat head on." So yeah, that was, that's another guy. Who else did I see? There was, what was it? Oh yeah, there was, these people returning stuff at Target. Oh my god, I've never heard such asshole people, like, return things. I've heard people be douchey returning things, but these people were so mad. This one lady was like, she had a cart full of stuff, and she's like, "I'm returning this stuff so I can get better deals on it." And they're like, "Ma'am, you can't do that." And she's like, "I bought this 2 days ago. I want to exchange it and get the Black Friday price for it." And then they're like, "You can't do that, ma'am. You should have just waited until Black Friday and then bought it." She's like, "This is unbelievable. I bought it the other day and now it's lower price. What am I supposed to do?" And I was like, "Oh my god. Just buy it on Black Friday, lady. Jesus." and then there was what was it? Oh yeah, this guy. This, like, probably late 30s, just douchey guy. And he had a big, like, what was it? Like one of those race car toys, like where you build the track, and then it goes around and whatever. And then he is like, "I just want to return this toy. I just want to return the track. I paid for it in gift cards." And they're like, "Sir, we need something about it." They needed the gift cards again, or like he wanted cash and they couldn't do it because he paid in gift cards or something else. And he was flipping his shit. He's like, "This is fucking stupid. This is a fucking outrage. I shouldn't fucking have to blah blah blah." And then they're just like, "Sir, if I was in your situation, I would also be upset, but we can't do anything if you'd like to contact the thing." And he's like, "This is fucking dumb. I can't believe you fucking people." And he was just like nonstop swearing, just like going crazy. And I was just like, "Dude, what is wrong with you?" It's insane. I don't know. It was just two insane people right next to each other. One lady freaking out, and then that guy freaking out. And I was like, "I'm gonna go people watch again." Thanks for the stream, Crendor. I'm great. You're great. I'm going to watch the cricket now. All right. Have fun. And thank you. Cat. Hey. Dreamweavers. Any good Dreamweaver quests? I always hate doing the Dreamweaver quests. The worst ones. Unless they got the squirrel quests. But they don't, so I don't care. I'll do them if they have the squirrel quests. I can go do the Nightfallen. Boop. Actually, I just have to do the Nightfallen normal quests. Oh, nice. Let's go right here and kill him. Let's do that. Not great. Dude, where's my water? Hold on, let me get water. Thank you. Doop-doop-doop.
Wow.
Wait, I was looking in Azuna for the Dreamweaver quest. Shit, dude. Damn it, there is the squirrel quest. I'm missing out.
Melisande's forces are waylaying refugees fleeing Suramar through the Crimson Thicket. A perfect opportunity to test their skills in battle.
And Fiora and her Nightborn troops. There's some Nightborn troops. Oh my god, you're sleepy. I'm getting sleepy too. But not like super sleepy, just like I wanna chill and play Pokemon sleepy. There's mana. Oh my god, are you kidding me?
Thanks.
Vapor Space resubbing 29 months in a row. 29 months of pain and suffering. Thanks, Vapor Space. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29. Swag. Let's get Captain Fiora. All right.
Enough, Bashar.
Well, that happened. That was easy. Oh my god, there's also at Target, I forgot about these people, there's this, I don't know how old they were, they sounded like they were 40, but they looked like they were like 17.
Inconceivable!
It's these like two girls, and they're there with their mom and their brother, I think? I don't know. But she looked like she was 60 years old, and then these girls were just like, the one's like, where's mom? And she's like, I don't know. She had like the deepest, like, James Bond villain voice. And I was like, what? I was like so taken out of place. So I was just walking, and then you like see these girls walking, and they're just like, whoa. And I'm like, what the shit? That was a Target. That's a Target, too.
Yeah.
much time did you spend in Target? I walked around it 3 times just to make sure I didn't miss any, like, funny things happening. So I probably spent, like, 40 minutes in there.
The situation is even more desperate than I imagined.
Alright, that's one out of the way. Still got 2 days to complete that one though. There's the mana one. Oh, that one's easy. How much mana do I have? I have 108. Hey, I realize there's a cat right here. Hello. Just chilling, watching me.
The Owl Kitten Patriarch, Yowlon, is having trouble herding his kittens back home. Look into those pies, champion. You cannot possibly leave them in danger.
Is it over here?
What?
Is this where they are? Oh, they're lost over here. Okay. And then this guy just walks in big circles. Back. Not this way. There we go. There we go. There we go.
Hmm.
Chakras 1. Let's go. If you pre-order the Sloth sweatpants now, you should be getting them very soon. They're supposed to be shipping this coming week. Like, the week after this current week. This current week? That's not even a word. This current week. When everybody gets back to work on Monday, that's when they're supposed to be shipping out. Well, the thing it says for being pre-ordered by the first, that was just so they get, that was just to reach 200 and get the orders fulfilled. But now that we're past that, pretty much nothing it says on that page, like, really matters. All that matters is, like, if you pre-order it, you'll get them. Not that way. I'm just gonna go to this one. There we go.
They relieve their sick, at least for now. Perhaps I should look into adoption.
Gotta get one more. 50 Nightborne forces slain. That sounds easy enough. I can just ride there.
The Nightborne continue to lay siege to the Moon Guard stronghold. Show them there are limits to their arrogance.
Okay.
Your death is certain.
My death is certain. Shit, dude. Oh wait, couldn't I have like Then that one quest where you just put the little bomb down and it kills like 50 of them. Probably could have. Maybe I can get up there.
You will bow to us!
I ain't bowing to no one. Oh shit, there they all are. Yeah, there we go. So now we just go over here. Put our trap down. And wait for it to go off. Why didn't it go off? Trap! Oh, there we go. Wait, it did go off. What? Oh, Jesus! There we go. Now we'll put the trap down right here. And then we wait. Here they come. Here comes a big pack of them. Or not. They'll split up. Well. Good night, Tina. Good night, Moon. Good night, cow jumping over the moon. Is that how Good Night Moon went? I don't actually remember. I think the last time I read it was when I made a WoW video about it. Set another trap. What class do I main? What do you suggest to get back in a while? I'll send class suggestions. I play a mage, as you can see. I enjoy mage. I think it's fun. You do get beat up a lot, you do take a lot of damage, but the damage you do is fun and crazy. And I definitely suggest getting back into WoW. This is the most fun I've had playing WoW since, oh my god. Did I just miss, like, killing all of them? Here we go, let's just go here. What? How'd they all die? Kidding me? Playoffs? Playoffs? What? Playoffs? Playoff? What? They keep just... Yeah. I think mage is fun. This is the most fun I've had in expansion since Wrath of the Lich King. And... yeah, that's that. Wait, is this the one... is this the one where you're supposed to get on the mount? I didn't think that was this one. Well, either way, I'll be able to do it by just setting traps. You're gonna miss WoW come next Sunday? What's next Sunday? Oh, this is the mount one then. Damn it, I like the mount one. Alright, maybe I'll just get on my mount. Jump down. Actually, I can glide. Let's see. Where's the mount? Where's the hippogriff thing at? Isn't it like down here, I think? What is this? Is it this thing? That's just a mana crystal. Fall hippogriffs. I thought I've done this already. Guess I'll do it again. I could have sworn I've already done these quests. Why do I have to do them again? What? It's outside the stronghold at the entrance. Three wild moonfall hippogriffs to do. Dude, I've done these quests already. Did I like reset them or something? I don't know. I'm gonna end up killing enough by the time I make it to the hippogriff thing. Alright, outside the stronghold. At the entrance. Over here? I don't see anything. I'll kill these guys in space.
Your fate is sealed!
Oh, it's down the road. By the flight path? Is it the flight path, lady?
What brings you here?
No. Oh, there's two or three entrances.
The Nightborn continue to lay siege to the Moonguard stronghold. Show them there are limits to their arrogance.
Okie dokie. Hell yeah. That's 50 manas. I mean, at this point, I'm better off just like killing him myself. The dragon's breath. I should have did that by all them.
For justice.
One by one, our foes shall fall.
Your star is fading!
Oh my gosh. Okay, I did like a zigzag.
Your star is fading!
Here we go. And one more. Hello, Kren. Hello, Arnosa.
Must not be allowed to breach the secrets of the Moonguard.
Rendor, bit of a noob, but do you have multiple abilities set in one key? What do you mean? I mean, like, I have my, all my abilities are set to different keys. And then, like, all these ones just don't show it, but, like, when I hit Shift 5, it does that. When I hit my mouse, it does decurse this one. This one. My other mouse is my B5, so it's just...
Aran Arcana.
Oh, I gotta feed her mana.
I shall never grow accustomed to that. We are only as strong as our will. Greetings.
What else they got? Ooh, I can buy stuff now here. Like the homemade party mask. Means a macro with multiple spells? Oh, definitely. I do not have that then, no. Someone in our guild just got two legendaries in a matter of, like, I think 10 minutes? Someone in our guild legit just got two legendaries in a matter of 10 minutes. They're a warlock, and they got the Power Cord of Lethendris, and their first legendary they got 10 minutes ago was Stretton's Sleepless Shackles. What the shit? Legit two legendaries in 10 minutes. That shit's insane.
Our isolation has ended. Do.
Don't worry. I can, let's see. I'll do this, of course. Here we go. Bam! That's not a legendary. Cool. That's one not a legendary at all. So we'll sell it. Sell that. Yeah, what is this? Oh, they're like the same thing, but it's not that. Okay. And those boots. Okay.
The Shalderai will be redeemed.
Okay. Do I like the legendary system? I actually do like it. I like that it adds like some suspense when everyone's like, oh my god, someone got a legendary, or like, oh, I got a legendary, or whatever. I actually don't mind it at all. It kind of has that like Diablo feel to it. I think that's what they're going for. I think that some of the legendaries are a bit strong compared to like other legendaries though, so it'd be nice if they like could balance it a bit better, but I think it's cool. Alright. I think I'm done. It's 4 a.m. and I wanted to play Pokemon. And then I'm going to go to bed because I'm tired. So, thank you everyone for watching. If you're new here, click the follow button. Follow along. Also, check out all links below the stream. There's a lot of them. Let's see, what else? So yeah, check out my new YouTube video. It's a new Krencast if you want to hear me rant for 30 minutes. That's now up on youtube.com/wowkrendor. And yeah. Thanks to everybody who subscribed, resubscribed, donated, dropped bits. I appreciate it. And yeah. Hello, Adoragon. I'm leaving now. Goodbye, Adoragon. So, see you later, everybody. And, yeah, happy Black Friday. Okay? Okay. I'll probably stream our raid tomorrow, actually, if we're raiding. See you. Where is the stop sign?